The thought came out of a need. The need was to provide something that wasn't at all taken into consideration. It's a very fundamental part of our industry, keeping your artists safe, keeping the people that safe, keeping fans safe. And so it's something that's been overlooked, despite them being such an important part. You know, the person you see at the door of every single event that we've done in the last 30 years, you know, have been part of these associations. And for the most part, you know, 99% of them are well-trained and know what they're doing. And of course, we need to support them because this is how they get better at what they do. So they get better by being supported. They get better at doing what they do by being supported by us. So I think it was easy for me to say, you know, these are people in need. And remember, clubs closed before we were even quarantined. So these guys have been out of work longer than any of us in this city. And I knew it was time. It was time to do something. Yeah, the bouncers receive posho. So we've got a ton of posho, a ton of beans. And they're going to receive this on behalf of us. Basically, it's a direct donation, you know, straight to them. And it's really just the start, hopefully. Hopefully we can do a lot of things. Of course, I just dropped my album as well. So we're trying to see how much of that funding we can basically throw back into the effort against COVID. I think really it shouldn't have taken as long as it did. But at the same point in time, you need to see the places that are most affected and do what you can. I keep telling Ugandans, whether you're donating 1 kg or 1 million, you need to see what you can do, what's in your capacity, and then just do it. You know, time, the timing always has to be right. Yes. Yeah.